ever so drawn this morning.
That bloody dog kept me awake. And there was that thing in the sky. The radio says it was an electrical storm, but I don't know what it was. This morning, I found some dead birds in the garden.
I'm sorry to hear that. I wonder if it might have had something to do with the atmospheric conditions.
Why, Stephen will probably know. I'll give him a call in a bit.
Wendy, I've popped around because we've had some incidents with some of the more elderly residents. Mrs. Boughton has, well, vanished, for want of a better word. Wandered off somewhere, no doubt. I thought I'd best check and see you're all right.
The council are talking about a flu epidemic.
Yes, well, I'm not sure it's flu as such. But no headaches, nosebleeds, no joint pains or digestive issues.
Dr. Wade, I'm as fit as a fiddle. Go and find some real sick people to look after. And if you see that son of mine, tell him that his mother's looking for him.
Thank you.
away, Amanda?
Oh, just for a few days, yeah. First thing in the morning. I don't want the kids to catch this flu if it's going round.
It's probably that Father Jeremy, spreading it around while he tries to bully everyone into donations for the summer fete.
It seems very quiet in the village, actually, Wendy. Not much bullying to be done.
Oh, Father, I didn't know you were here.
Clearly. Listen, I came up here to tell Amanda that we've had some vandalism in the village. Must be a teenage thing. Tagging, I think they call it. Someone's painting all over doors and things.
Little vandals. Well, I'll tell Neil to make sure we're properly locked up when we go.
A good man like my Eddie gone. And these thugs and yops running around defacing property. He gave everything to his country, and look what he got in return. Nothing but an early death.
He had a good life, Wendy.
He had a short life. I look to my birds, Father. Lives lived unencumbered, free and simple. That's as God meant things to be.
Computer in the observatory has set itself to 6:07 a.m. June 6th, 1984. I don't understand what that means.
And substation before we cut the lines. The interchange there just started dialing numbers at random.
And the symptoms you're seeing match those we've been tracking here?
Sickness, headaches, nosebleeds, eventual hemorrhage, then just light, whatever the hell that means.
Then we've got to stop it before it finds another way out of the valley. Clive, You've got to order a strike.
What?
An airstrike. We have to kill it.
No. No, I don't agree. We've quarantined the valley, we've cut the lines. It's contained.
What if you're wrong? Are you happy to have that on your conscience?
Stephen, I said it's contained.